Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let me show you how to search for files in two or more different folders at the same time in the Finder. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you search for files in Spotlight or the Finder, you can look in your entire hard drive or in a specific location like your Documents folder or a subfolder in that. But what if you wanted to look in two different folders, two folders that were in different locations on your hard drive at the same time? Not all the folders at the same level, but two completely different folders. Let me give you an example. Here I've got a folder called Project A and under that a folder called Some Files. And let's say I want to look for files that happen to be in there. But I also want to look in Project B, and here's another folder with some files in it. I want to search in both of those places. Now, in this example, there aren't many files in those two locations, but imagine in a situation where you had hundreds or thousands of files in different folders in different places, and you just wanted to search in those places, not at the top level and see everything that you've got. Let's dig down here to the first folder, and if I do Command F for Find, you could see here that I could search either this Mac, the entire Mac, all of my files, or the current folder. So I have the current folder selected. But there's no way to add another folder to this. There's no modification here that will allow me to say, look for files in these two, three, or four specific folders. But of course, there always is a way without using any third-party software or anything. You just have to get a little tricky. So first, let's go and look for files in here by name. And let's say name contains, and let's use the word notes. And you can see there are four files in that folder that have the word notes in them. I also want to include files with the word notes in the name in that other folder as well. So the first thing I want to do is save the search. I'm going to click save here, and it will create a saved search, also known as a smart folder. And it will do it in the save searches location, which is actually in my library folder. I don't want to put it there because I want to work with this special file. So instead, I'm going to go to my Documents folder here. I'm going to create a new folder called Special Searches. Just a place to put this. And I'll hit Create. And I'll call this something like Search for Notes. And I'll save it. And you can see I also added it here to the sidebar. So I can easily click here and use it. Let's go back up into the Documents folder here into Special Searches. And here's that saved search file. Now what we're going to do here is modify it manually so it includes both of those folders. So I'm going to run TextEdit. I'm going to use Spotlight to search for TextEdit and run TextEdit. And I'm going to drag and drop the saved search special file there and open it up in TextEdit. And this is what's actually in that file. It's a text file. It's perfectly readable, containing all of the criteria for that search. You can even see here that the raw query is looking for a display name that includes notes with anything before or anything after it. And then here, if we look at search scopes, we could see the path inside an array. An array means a list of things. So we have a list of one thing, one path. So you think we could add a second path there. But before we do that, notice that in addition to search scopes, there's also current folder path, and there's an array in there with the same path. And if we look further down, we'll see FX scope array of paths with that path yet again. So it's there in three places. Now, some experimentation shows that I could actually add a second path here to this FX scope array of paths, and it will work. But I think it's a little cleaner if I add it in all three places. So let's create a new line here, and I will format it the same way. So I'll tab over, use string here, and then slash users, and then my username, documents. Now that second folder was actually in Project B slash, and the name of it was actually notes and such. And then I will close the little tag there like that. Now let's add that in the other two places. So I'll copy it and I'll move here and I'll hit return. I'll tab over and I'll paste it in. So now we have the second path added under current folder path. And also I'm going to do the same thing here, but the format is a little different. So I'll paste it in, but notice that it goes to the top level, System Volumes Data, and then slash Users. So let's go and add that. So now it matches the same format, but this time it's looking in Documents Project B, Notes and Such, instead of Some Files. So now I've added it in those three places. So now I'm going to Save from Text Edit and close the document. So now it's saved it there. So if I double click on this, it should show me the results of the search for notes in both of those locations. But it doesn't. If I double click, you can see I still see the same results. So what's going on here? Well, we need to restart the Finder. So I'm going to exit out of this to make sure I'm not in there. So now I just went back and I could just see the saved search file. Now I could restart the Finder one of several ways. I can do it in the terminal. I can do it by force quitting the Finder. But I could also hold the Option key down, click on the Finder down here, and you could see there's Relaunch. Let's select that. All my Finder windows will close and open. You may want to make sure you're not running any other apps when you're doing this. And now I can double click on this, and the results are going to be all the files with notes in the name from both folders. Matter of fact, if I click here and I look at the bottom, I could see the path bar. And I can see this is from Notes and Such. This one is from Some Files. Notes and Such, Some Files. So it is actually showing me the results from both of those locations. I can even modify this now that I've created it. I can click here and go to Show Search Criteria. And you can see now it says Search This Mac, and then it just gives me the name of the saved search here at the top. But I could change the criteria here at the top. So in addition to notes, another word that I used was things. So now if I look here, I could see some of these are in Some Files and others are in Notes and Such. So I can change what I'm searching for very easily. I can't really change the actual locations without opening it up again in TextEdit. And if I go to Exit here, it's going to ask me to save the Smart folder. I will. And if you go look in the text file, sometimes you'll see that the path's only in two places now instead of one. I'm not sure why the difference, but it still does work. And I can return, say, to the Documents level here and click in the sidebar and get the results for the saved search. So this isn't the most convenient way to do this. And of course, if you want to clutter your Mac with more third-party apps, you can get search apps that will do more. You can also do this in the terminal as well. But while this isn't very convenient to do just a quick one-time search, it is a good way to set up a saved search that can search multiple locations and you can keep going back to it time and time again. Plus, you also get some insight as to how saved searches work, and perhaps you can play around with more of the details inside of the text of the saved search file. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.